Hi, I'm Hari Krishna. I'm Menon. I'm a mechanical engineer. I have cleared GATE twice. Today's topic is history of construction, how buildings came into the form as how it is right now. Consider a situation where you have a truck loaded with sand. Now if you unload it, it will obviously take a form of a cone, that is a conical heap is formed. Has anyone thought about the reason why it is cone, not spherical, not cylindrical, not any other shape? Yes, one fellow has thought about why it is conical. Now, to understand why it is conical, you need to know one more concept, that is center of gravity, which most of the engineers might be knowing. So general concept. Still, to explain center of gravity, for example, if you take a rectangle, everybody has a center of gravity, but let me take a rectangle. There is a point about which whole weight of this rectangle is concentrated or is acted upon. This is the point about which the whole weight of the rectangle is acted on. That is the center of gravity. Now, you need to know one more parameter now. It's just a small parameter, I am defining it. Let this be the ground. And let this rectangle be on this ground. This is the CG, or center of gravity actually, of the body. Now, this distance, that is the distance from the ground to center of gravity, let it be X. Okay, this is the parameter. Now this X is very important, because what is this X is, it defines the stability of the body. How? As and as X decreases, that is center of gravity, as and as it approaches ground, that is X decreases, as X decreases, stability of the structure increases. That is, as and as X decreases, stability increases. It means stable structure will be formed when X is the least. Now considering shapes, some shapes like triangle, rectangle, circle. We have same height. Okay, we have this, all these are the same height. Then if we consider the X value, that is here X1. Here it's x2, here it's x3, we have even more shapes, we can draw even more shapes, many shapes are there. But if you check, it is the least for a triangle. And it is a 2D structure. But for the 3D structure, it is the minimest or the least for the cone. And if it is the minimest, that implies X decreases, implies stability increases, implies X is the least for cone, and it implies stability is the highest for cone. That is the reason why nature is automatically turning this unloaded sand heap into conical structure. Therefore, it is in taking the conical shape. Now, you might be asking, it is the most stable structure, then why didn't you use it in building? Like if you could have made the buildings in the form of a cone, why didn't you build in the form of a cone? But later on, what happened, someone invented or discovered maybe the fact that if you consider this cone, the center of gravity of this cone is here, CG. Let's take CG1. Now if you cut this and remove this, then the CG will go below, down, that is CG2. Now the X1, which was here, has transformed into X2, that is yet below. That means X2 is less than X1. That is, X value has decreased after removing this portion. It implies that frustum is even more stable than cone. So frustum is the best now. Now people will be asking, why not frustum, why people are not using frustum as a structure to build buildings and all those things. And my dear friends, they have built, we have built thousands of structures. Burj Khalifa is a frustum. Kutub Minar is a frustum. Eiffel Tower is a frustum. Shanghai Tower is a frustum. Tokyo skyscraper is a frustum. Even the chimneys of factories are a frustum. Is a frustum because it's a tall structure, and it to be stable, it should be taking the shape of a most stable structure, that is frustum. Yes, everywhere it is used. Now people will ask one thing. Why not flats, multi-story buildings, like people who flats and all, they would be thinking why it is not made in the form of frustum, because it should also be in the form of frustum. Yes, my dear friends, they are also in the shape of frustum. How? Let's check. You have a building. How to prove it? How to prove that it is taking the shape of a frustum? You might be staying in a multi-story building, or maybe some of your friend might be staying in a multi-story building. Go to that place and check. Go to the ground floor and ask the person what is the carpet area. That is the area which is taken in by the ground, or maybe you can take it as an area there, ground floor. Now go to the top floor and ask the carpet area there, here, the top floor. 101% it's sure that the carpet area here will be greater than, more than here. That means there is a small taper. There is a small taper given to the buildings. But the problem, but the thing is, we don't find this taper. We can't see it through the naked eyes. We can only experience it by asking the people on the top floor and the bottom floor about their carpet areas. This decrease is helping them to be stable, but not as they are not as tapered as Burj Khalifa, Qutub Minar, etc. Why? Because they need to be economical too. They are not as rich as the people who have built Burj Khalifa, etc. So that economic consideration into fact, designers have tried to decrease the taper angle, but taper angle is necessary and very important thing to have a perfect design. So that explains the reason of construction. How people have started to construct big, huge buildings, which like, for example, you can consider Burj Khalifa, which is 829 meters, which is just short of a kilometer. That is a very huge structure, and this is because of this identification of the most stable structure, which is a frustum. And here it explains the history of construction. Thank you.